Hello everyone, this is Mr. Random Generator. In this video, I will be showing you a project that I have made a year ago, which is a digitalized Enigma machine. So, as you can see, I've made it in a basic plastic box and wrap it around with some carbon vinyl wrap. And it does have a few basic controls. If you are familiar with Enigma machine, you will know that it does have some rotors, keyboards that you type on, and another keyboard that you see the outcome of the encrypted letter. If you don't know, I'll provide a link in the description so you can check out an awesome video made by the channel number file so you can see how that works in detail. Anyway, so how that thing works. So in my case, I do have these three displays, seven segment displays, which basically correspond to rotors in an original Enigma machine. And I have a dot matrix display, which we will be displaying letters on it. As you can see, we have a basic on-off switch and an encryption and decryption switch. And we have a dial there, which is a multifunction dial, which helps us to select the rotor positions and also choose the letter as well. So, how it works? Well, first we need to power that on. Initially, I have actually created a plug for it, but later on I need it for another project, so I just take basic USB wire and solder it into it. And by the way, we will see it inside in just a second. So, this unit is actually powered between 12 volts and 12 volts. So, I have power bank near here, so we can use that as our power source. Let's just quickly plug it in, turn it on, and switch it on. Yeah, there we go. As you can see, it's now it's powered on. We have minor defect right there. It is probably caused by some defective wiring inside that, but anyway, it's not a big issue, I think. So let's start by putting it into the encryption mode and choose our rotor positions. Let's say easy to remember 10, 10, and 10. So now if I change the dial position, as you can see, we can choose letters. Let's say we choose key K. Press it. It encrypts to K again. So that is actually a nice coincidence, so we can easily remember the outcome. So now we switch back to the decrypt position and hold that down in order to reset everything. So now we reset everything, we just go back to the initial position, which is 10, 10. Let's go to the K and we press it. As you can see, it goes back to K. Actually, it is not a good demonstration since it basically does the same. Let's try so another one. Let's reset it. Yeah, so there we go. Back to the encrypt mode. Oh, actually, we chose the 0, so reset it again. Let's go. Let's go 555. Let's choose L. L encrypted into U. So we switch back to decrypt mode, reset it again back to 000. Again, we go to the same position, 5, 5, and 5. Now, if I go to U, K, L, M, if we press that, and it doesn't work. Actually, it does that sometimes. Actually, I think it first registered my pressed and doesn't display it. It actually has some feedback, but you'll get the idea. So let's look at the insides of it. Let's close it and open it up. At there, I have a basic voltage regulator which converts 5 between 5 and 12 volts into the 5 volts, which is fed into STM32, and that is basically the brain of this project. It does all encryption and decryption stuff. It is basically actually an Arduino on steroids. But anyway, at there I've created a few boards that is basically controllers for the 7-segment displays and the dot matrix one. So this is the dot matrix, and this back in there is the 7-segment display. So if you look at those are all home etched and stuff like that. But actually, at the time I made this project, I only have single layered copper PCBs. So what I did was, since the routing the lines on it is pretty complex, so I just created double-sided design, so the traces will be much simpler. And then I've etched it and matched those holes and super glued them together. It's really janky solution, so, but it kinda works actually. So that is basically the summary of this project. Hope you like that. And I will provide the GitHub link in the description, so you can maybe want to create your own, and you can go ahead and look at the code and stuff like that. Hope you like it. See you next time. Take care. Bye.